at that point of time also, Atal Bihari Vajpayee had vested in a lot in improving the relationship with Pakistan. What Pakistan did after that is historically known. Now, what I would like to ask you, Zafar Hilali, is this. Our present Prime Minister has also vested in a lot, despite strong Indian public opinion in somehow keeping this process going with your country. But you see this aborted attack on the Jalalabad consulate a few days back, in which there was a clear hand.
May I just clarify one thing? The Afghans have informed us officially that the attack on our consulate was carried out by four members of the Lashkar-e-Taiba, Punjabi speaking, who came across the border illegally and executed that attack, which was foiled.
So the question here is that first you have to get your army under check, Zafar Hilali, before you can have any constructive dialogue. I'm sure you completely agree.
First of all, let me just say that the Lashkar-e-Taiba has probably killed more Pakistanis than it has killed Indians.
It has not. That's the first point.
Sorry, Zafar.
The Lashkar has never, unlike the Jaish and other groups, carried out an attack inside Pakistan. It is a favorite not only of the military for that reason, but also, and it is not sectarian.
And the other is a favorite of the military,
and also has enjoyed the patronage of the Sharif family.
Let him continue.
Mr., you see, the point is this, that if you think that you believe whatever they say, and you think that your take is better than the take we have of our problem, then perhaps you can say these things. But let me tell you, there's half a dozen of one and six of the other. There is no real difference between these organizations. Some of them are supposed to be closer, some of them are supposed to be more distant, some of them are supposed to be good, some of them are supposed to be not so good, but we know through bitter experience that they're all the same. They are all against the constitution of Pakistan, they are all against peace and stability. So if you want to make a distinction, you're welcome. I am not welcome making it.
Why is Nawaz Sharif funding them? Why is Nawaz Sharif funding them?
Now, the point is this, there are indeed some parties in Pakistan that are accused of having some kind of contacts with some of these organizations. I think that if that was the situation in the past, I think the situation in Pakistan is completely transformed. You heard the Interior Minister of Pakistan yesterday say, we are in it for our lives. We are in it for our existence.
Zafar Hilali, the view in India is, get your house in order. I am told that Kiani may go. There may be a new army chief. There may be a change of guard in your army. Let the change of guard happen. Let Nawaz Sharif get control, and then we'll talk. That's all.
Well, first of all, to talk in the given situation appears rather meaningless. Apart from your last comment regarding getting a house in order is the demand not only of you but of the Pakistani people. We all want to get our house in order. It's not going to be easy, but we are determined to.
Are you going to make it more difficult
by your virulent anti-Pakistan propaganda, your jingoistic stance, your widespread shelling of an incident which, by the way, hasn't at all been proved that it was committed by the Pakistan army? What I am astonished is, you never talk about the fact that who could have done this. You take it for granted. And your foreign minister said, because there are terrorists, it could be one or the other.
Mr. Zafar Hilali, Seshadri Chari is responding to you, please. Yes.
Zafar Saab should also explain to us that are these non-state, so-called non-state actors whom he is referring to, do you mean to say the army has absolutely no control over these people? Does the ISI not control these people? Number one. Number two, if this was an act, as he claims, a small incident, some other guest, another guest from Pakistan referred to this as an incident. It is not a single one, single incident. There have been more than 15 violations in last one week. In the first place, do you mean to say that these elements are so brazen and bold enough to breach the army at the border, LOC, come inside the Indian territory, kill 5 jawans, go back unnoticed and unstopped by the Pakistani army? Is the Pakistani army so weak? And if it is this kind of a weakness that the Pakistani army is showing, I think it is time for Mr. Kayani to go, and then the Indian Prime Minister will have to talk a very tough language to Pakistan before he meets the Prime Minister in New York. And that is the mood of the people of India, and that has been expressed overtly by the parliament resolution.
Now,
and I will also refer to another guest who said that Pakistan is also a nuclear country, and your resolution specifically speaks
I don't want to get derailed in rhetoric. I have only one question today.
This is the kind of threat. This is the kind of threat that Pakistan is holding towards India.
Want to respond.
Arnav, I am reading out from the Pakistani resolution.
Go across to our Pakistan guest.
I am reading out from the Pakistani resolution that we shall continue to extend diplomatic, political and moral support for the just and legitimate struggle of Kashmiri people.
You have dual power centers.
The Indian
they are talking about extending support to Kashmiri people.
Your government
is the
no
Indian
control
army
over Mr.
so
right
incompetent?
Now. Why should we
is
be
the
complicit?
Indian army so incompetent?
Why should we be complicit
that in the most
such a process,
heaviest
talking to somebody
militarized
we don't know anything about?
Land on earth, that is occupied Kashmir, is the most militarized land in the world. Is your army so incompetent that they allow a Pakistani patrol to come in 5 miles, kill somebody while they are in a siesta and return back?
Mr. Zafar Ilali, I have told you before and I am repeating now. I know the strength of Indian army. The Indians know the strength of Indian army. I am neither a diplomat nor a journalist. I am telling you point blank now. If you want to show the strength, if you want to see the strength of the Indian army, we can show the strength of the Indian army that we showed in 1971. So don't make me repeat these things.
Try it.
And you cannot threaten us like this. Therefore, if you want talks, if you want peace with India, you should learn to behave.
Let's try it.
If you want peace with India, you also should learn.
Let's not provoke, calm down the tempers. I only raise the point of why we should talk to some countries, which is not
try to behave.
We should give more time to our Pakistani guests. The basic point is that Mr. Hilali should know the terrain. You know, the only thing within 1,000 yards of that post on the LOC is a Pakistani post on the other side. There is nobody else there. And this was a patrol moving late, dark at night.